the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three.
Yeah.
Who are Areno, whoop, Raikkonen, and whoop, Sebastian Vettel. It's time to leave for now, but we'll be back tomorrow when the Grand Prix... Who would have imagined in those pioneering days of motor racing just how far and wide the love of speed and competition would spread? From Brands Hatch to Jerez to Valencia, the European Grand Prix has made its home all across the continent. And now a new era of this storied race brings us here to the edge of the Caspian Sea. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4-mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. Anthony Davidson joins me today as we look ahead to something just a little bit different. It's quite high speed for a street circuit here, isn't it? Do you think that's going to throw up any unexpected situations?
Well, as long as the teams can keep everything cool, I don't foresee any particular big issues from a technical side of things. I do expect the track to be quite slippery, though. We've not exactly had much chance to rubber in the surface. Any street circuit also comes with its own challenges, so I think we'll be seeing a few mistakes here and there. The smart strategy would be to expect a safety car, I think, especially early on when the pack is bunched up.
Okay, remember to protect the inside on the run down to turn one. Make yourself as wide as possible, robust, but fair.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It's Reno in pole position then, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Rosberg, Lewis Hamilton, and Bottas, Verstappen, Massa, Ricciardo, and Daniel Kvyat, Sainz, Grosjean, Kevin Magnussen, and Gutierrez, Hülkenberg, Nasser, Marcus Ericsson, and Fernando Alonso, Perez, and Button, Rio Haryanto, and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, oh boy. Pole position. Fuck, let's just get underway. The tires are very soft, at least I'm pretty okay here. Soft tires are gonna last easily. I think I can do one stop, but that's really, really stretching it. Tires are really gonna die here near the end. So, 8 laps, softs, 8 laps at the end. So, 8, 9, 8. Find some meat, and let's do what I did last time. Throw in a 2 kilos or 2.5 kilos extra. And let's roll! Let's get off the line. I don't feel like doing the whole.
Clutch bite is good. Gearbox is responding normally.
Clutch bite is good. I fucked it up. Alright, but good thing we can just skip it and I don't feel like doing it anymore. Okay, here we are for the race. Attempt number, I don't know what. I don't know what it is here on this track. Won't let me live here. Alright, very strong opening lap. Pass Raikkonen for second. Glad I got a steady frame right now in this game. Enough, it's still not quite perfect, but this game could use some further optimization. I hear that a lot of people on Nvidia cards are struggling. Like a second and a half. Alright, survived the first pit entry. Again. There is Lewis coming through. I wonder if I can get out ahead of any of the guys behind. That means I'm already a full pit stop. I can. Alright. It's a 19 second pit lane. Question is Lewis on a one stop or two stop? I've not committed myself to a two stop. Victory is definitely not in the bag yet. Driver in front.
Hamilton is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 3.8 seconds. You're taking 1.8 seconds out of them each lap. The time last lap was a 1 minute 48.2.
So I need about 20-21 seconds to come out ahead of Lewis on the final stop. Let's see if we can do that. Sainz in third, hello. Was he in event? May stretch this stint by one more lap. I mean, the tyres easily have it, I believe. Yeah, they're fine, and even below 30%. not gonna pit at the end of this lap, at the end of the next one. See what happens. Just in front or just behind? I hope in front. Come on, come on, come on. 2.4 is a good stop. Right, 20 seconds. Oh, just in time. Yes, go team. Tire information.
There's 8 laps of fuel remaining. We have a small amount of extra fuel.
Guess it doesn't have tire information. To a fastest lap, I hope. Boom! 6 tenths off. Vehicle condition? So vehicle condition is tires. At least mostly tires. Last lap time. Still a second faster than him. Not on his lap, probably. Driver behind. Last lap.
That last lap was a 1:46.9.
We're about 4 tenths quicker on that lap. The AIs are not driving like morons. Oh, the finish line was already there. Okay. Yes, I did. Way too much work. Maybe I want to think about it.
So, another fantastic victory for Renault today.
Whew, man.
And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimize each stint and get the most out of the tires. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well.
And Nico happy with 1 point.
Without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
Would you say that in the actual season?
See, it's time for the podium, and I can see the Renault team underneath our commentary box going crazy as their drivers walk out.
Driver.
It was a great win, and it means a great deal to this team.
You know, always does, doesn't it? Formula One Grand Prix of Europe, Baku. Oh, hey, it's a longer one.
And after this round slightly of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Difficult call, Crofty, but I'd like to say Sergio Perez. He's just
yes,
so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that here today.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.
Alright, so it's a win for me. Lewis second, Kimi third, Nico Rosberg, Sainz in fifth. Damn, well done, son. Perez eighth, double points finish for Force India, 1 point or 2 points for Alonso. Where did a teammate end up? Only 14th. So, who did all two stop? I did, Kimi did, Kvyat did, Massa did. And Ricciardo did, but he had a problem. Oh my god, they fell way the fuck back. Look at that. Bad, bad day for Red Bull. They lost a lot of points here today. Alright, so anything crazy that happened? Any incidents? Only two. Collision with Verstappen got a warning, and Bottas got a mechanical failure on lap. I think that was the... can't even remember if we had a virtual safety car. Alright, let's just look at the start. So... clean getaway at the front. Further back, Lewis overtaking Vettel. Just about. By then, me and Kimi were already gone. Section in third, okay. Interesting. Interesting. Alright, accidentally paused the recorder, so here we are again.
And now let's take a look at the driver's standings.
Ooh, made it back
it
up to second
again.
For
our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced.
Up to second.
Now I'd like to ask you,
1 point ahead of Lewis.
Who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Sergio Perez. That was a commanding performance today.
Kevin didn't get any points, actually. He's still dry.
Extended their lead at the top of the standings.
So we're not going to get a constructor since I'm the only one getting them points so far.
A strong weekend from them as they find their way towards the top.
They're already 60 points out of Ferrari. Yeah, shush. So, that's our third victory this year, I think. Let's check the trophy room. Hey, made all the clean laps. What's up? Penalty 3-2. Nice. Positions gains plus 0. Excellent. Well, this is all practice sessions, some extra bonus points. It's not a whole lot, but every little bit helped. This, I smoked him here today, I think. Got everything here. Boop. Yes. Yep. Yes. Alright, so I only have to get 2 points to nail him. This should be doable. It's gonna be 1-1 in that rivalry. Revelry. Though I'm probably gonna get someone way up the field with that. Nice. Alright, so what do we wanna go for? I think we want more downforce. I like the downforce. I'm gonna focus on these two. You also have the ability to cease development at some point, but I don't want to do that quite yet. So we're gonna get some fuel efficiency. It's not too important, but helpful anyway, I guess, overall speaking. Oh my, that's almost way down. Oh damn. We're gonna get that for the next weekend. That's nice. All right, so see you guys for the next race. I'm not sure which one it is in the calendar. Oh yes, we're gonna look at the trophy room. I said, didn't I? To count the wins. Yeah, third, fourth. No, yeah, third. Yeah, there you go. Bahrain, China. That was the wet weather race, in which the AI was surprisingly slow. Bahrain, which the safety cars helped me out. There's that third place of Canada. Then bad 19th. An up and down season, as you can tell. I mean, a bad race in Australia, which you've seen, and two great ones, then a crap one where I crashed out in Russia, then a good one in Spain again with drying conditions, and then yeah, the poor performance in Monaco, which you didn't see, and then the good performance in Canada, which you also didn't see because of all the recording issues. So yeah, not doing too badly at all. Let's see where we can end up at the end of the season and how early we should stop development and just save up as many points so we can blast into next season, because you get quite a bonus by seizing development earlier. Like a 25% bonus or something, so the more points you have, the better you will be the start of next season. You can invest heavily. So yeah, bye bye.